I'm fed up with changes. Come pick me up, cause I just wanna see the light. I wanna be weightless. Teach me to fly, I won't be coming down. Could somebody wake me up? I don't wanna be here and let the world pass me by. Yeah.
I just see. What I'm doing here is cutting these into nice quarter-inch chunks. With the guanciale, or any other meat that you decide to use, you're going to cook it nice and slow in the pan. And by cutting it this thick, it allows the meat to cook down nice and slow, and a lot of these beautiful flavors will start coming out as the fats and the meat and everything starts to render down.
I'm so sick of waiting and getting too restless to be in this dusty town. I've heard of this place where people forget and you get another try. So come open up my door. I don't wanna be here and let the world pass me by. I won't see your face.
A tip that I have with the guanciale, now that we're watching this process right now, and you can see that there's a pretty decent sized cubes here, is that I don't like my guanciale too salty, and you can see when you're working with it that there's a lot of salt on it. It's salty to begin with, but with the curing process, there's a lot more salt put on there. So I actually like to rinse it off a little bit before I put it into the pan, just to get some of the salts off and a lot of the raw flavor from the meat itself will start to come through. You can see here that I put in some olive oil. My pan was a little too hot at the time, so you can see it start to smoke, which is fine, it's okay. So I ended up turning the flame off and swirling around the oil right behind just to get it to cool down just a little bit. And with the pan still off, I went ahead and added the guanciale, and just waited for the pan to cool off a little bit more before turning it back on. What we want to do here is just a very nice slow heat. I typically take around 10 to 15 minutes to render the fats and everything in the guanciale and cook it all in.
This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me. As I was walking that ribbon of highway, I saw above me that endless skyway. I saw below me that golden valley. This land was made for you and me. Follow my footsteps to the sparkling sands.
Alright, so now we're prepping the main ingredient for the sauce, which is the eggs and the cheese. This part is probably the most important step of your of this dish, right? So it's important to get the texture right, more so than the quantity that you put here. So I always mix a little extra than I need and then add it in little by little. And you can see here what I'm doing is a 75-25 split of the pecorino and the Parmesan cheese. And what I'm doing is slowly mixing into the eggs. That was kind of a big job. But I slowly mix in the eggs just to get it nice and mixed up and start making a nice, thicker, gritty style mixture here that you can see. Alright, now I didn't show this process, but while you're cooking your guanciale and making the egg and cream mix, you want to go ahead and start boiling your pasta. You want to cook it about 1 to 2 minutes less than what it says on the package, and right when you're about to take the pasta out, you want to save like a good mug full of water. You want that starch water. You're going to use it later on to finish cooking and to make a nice cream. I'll show you here in just a second. So right now we put a new pan back on. We turn the heat on, we're going to drop the guanciale in, I'm going to throw a little cracked pepper on top of it, and then we're going to go ahead and add some of that starch water to start building some of the creams.
Dark sacred night, and I think to myself, oh, what a wonderful world. Of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? What they're really saying is, I love you.
When I added this mix, you can see that I only added about half of the bowl there, which is probably equivalent to 2 eggs and half of the cheese that we mixed up. And what I'm doing is it's completely off the flame. We don't want any heat at all. If you put heat on this, your cheese will get nasty and stringy. So take it off the heat, let the pasta cool down for a second, mix the cheese in, and you will start to get this nice, nice creamy texture. Scoop it out, throw it in. If you find that it's not enough cheese, add some more mixture. If you find it's too wet, that's okay. When you scoop it out, just leave some of the excess sauce behind. Sprinkle a little extra black pepper on top of it, and you're done. Enjoy.